Hello, I'm Sarospa, bringing you a new episode of Gaming Archaeology with Ape Escape. I just really wanted to make sure to capture that opening because I love it. So yeah, I've been looking forward to this one, so I ended up moving it ahead of the list. Believe me, Mischief Makers is coming, but right now, we're gonna play some Ape Escape. Oops. Hopefully that didn't pick up too loud.
Hey, Spike! Did the professor finish the time station yet? Are we gonna get to go back in time?
He said he'd be finished with it today. Let's go!
I can't wait to check out the dinosaurs. And what about the future?
Yeah, we'll keep talking, because I'm going first.
That's not fair!
Talking about it like they're going on a field trip.
Hey,
come on, it's time travel.
Spike, Jake, over here, watch out.
Spike, the time station.
No, run you two.
Well, that's pretty bad.
It works. It actually works.
I love the expression on the girl's face.
We did it. The time station is complete.
We don't have time for celebrating. We've got to do something.
We need to remove these rope textures.
Spike, can you hear me? You must listen carefully. Something awful has happened. There's been an accident. The time station has been activated by Specter and you're being transported back in time. You'll soon arrive in the Lost Land when dinosaurs roam the Earth. Specter has sent the apes back in time to try to change the course of history. His plans for world domination have begun. And if we don't stop the apes, history will be changed forever. You're our only chance. Two of my gadget inventions, the Stun Club and the Time Net, were also caught in the transport. I want you to use them to catch the apes and send them back here. The Stun Club can be used to defend yourself against attackers. And when you use it on the apes, they'll be stunned. And you'll have an extra second to catch them with the time net. There isn't time for any monkey business, Spike. Our fate is in your hands. We're depending on you. Be careful.
Sorry, I wasn't listening. I was trying to think of Planet of the Apes references. What was that? Okay, no, seriously. So, if you don't know anything about Ape Escape, well, for once, pretty much everything was covered by the game itself.
Let's go!
So, long story short, super intelligent apes with goofy helmets done fucked up history and we have to fix it. This game is also a bit unique in that it's, I think, the only PlayStation game that actually requires the only one that actually requires the use of the right analog stick on the DualShock controller.
Gotcha.
Trying to remember if do other games actually use the right analog stick? That's like generally for camera control, right? I want to say it might be the only one to actually make use of the right analog stick at all, but I might be overselling it a little bit. But yeah, so basically, you use left analog stick for movement, and this has a bit of a unique control scheme in that the right analog stick is used to give you radial actions Oh, and you can do that too. So you can actually like swing your club or your net in any direction that you'd like. Can we like stealth these guys? No, not really. By the way, what's with the Goombas wandering around? What are they? Are they supposed to be dinosaurs? But yeah, so the object of the game is just to go around catching monkeys. Now, despite their super intelligence, they're actually generally not that smart, as you can see. So, they do get trickier to catch as time goes on. You'll have monkeys with different gimmicks that make it harder for them to track down.
You did great!
And now we're in the space thing, I guess. Yeah. So let's go. But yeah, this is actually a game I've been meaning to go back to for a long time. Not even to LP, just to play, but somehow I just never really got around to it.
Look what I've got, a new gadget. Check it out.
This is the water net. Use it when you're underwater. I equipped it with an oxygen meter. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training room. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful.
What he's saying is that the training room is obligatory. Not that I really mind that much. I think it's probably not a bad idea. Just from around using the left stick. Okay. It does take a little bit of getting used to the controls. Because as you can see here, the face buttons are used as basically like an item wheel, and you jump with R1 and R2, I guess. And then the left shoulder buttons are camera control. So it does take some getting used to that, X isn't jump, but you know, it can be pushed in like a button. Okay. Give it a shot, then. So yeah, I think that this game pretty thoroughly makes use of the functionality of the DualShock controller. You could probably do it without it, but it would probably not be as convenient. It seems like with the whole like item wheel thing, they just kind of went for like maximizing the tools they have available. This was probably pretty late in the PS1's life cycle, so it was probably a good bet that a lot of people own the DualShock controller. It's actually kind of weird going back to the old PS1 controller, because you know, it wasn't even it wasn't even like the main controller used throughout. Man, I didn't pay any attention to what they said. Hey, at least I can admit it. The right stick, okay. Okay, so down, and ooh, this is a little awkward. Okay. Dive and net. There we go. Okay, it's not so bad. Hopefully that we're not gonna have too much underwater monkey catching. Okie dokie. So yeah, you get a lot of new gadgets over time, which will enable you to go back and catch monkeys that you weren't able to get before. Because as you can see from the status screen at the opening, we don't actually have to catch all the monkeys to proceed. So
let's go!
You might have to in order to like to get, I can't remember if you're required to get all of them to like beat the game. That's probably not true. Okay, so let me see if I can use the stun club, because it's got a little bit more reach. You come back here, you damn dirty ape. I mean, okay, that's the obvious one. Double jump? Okay. Guys, I'm trying to catch a monkey here. Yeah, alright. Look, we'll come back to this, okay? There we go. I'm still a little slow on the item wheel, but, I'll get used to it. So, definitely, getting used to the non-standard control scheme here. Ooh, what the heck are those things? I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that, the depictions of the creatures in this time period are probably not historically accurate. I don't know. I just, I don't believe that Sniffits lived alongside dinosaurs. There's just no historical evidence for that. Sneak? Okay, so I can sneak. I just have to be, sneaky. That's pretty cool. I like that. It's a little bit of stealth going on. Can we get that guy? There's like no way to get over there. Can I actually like... Wait. Shit. Come on. There we go. Where's Nessie? Use... this guy to, come on. I don't think he's happy about that. Gotcha. Okay. Monkey. Hell yeah.
Yes.
I'm gonna be honest, when I'm done with this episode, I'm probably just gonna keep playing Ape Escape. I love this.
You did great.
Let's see. Wow, we're only 14 minutes in. Let's keep going. Let's do it. Ah, yes, lethal lava land. Am I gonna get a new gadget? Nope, we're going right into it. Let's see, 4 out of 7. I wonder what those special coins are for. Actually, not sure. Man, this game's got a pretty sweet soundtrack so far, too. It's very upbeat, I like it.
Let's go!
Yes, okay. You fall off your finish. All right. Don't walk off a cliff. I got it. The tutorial mailboxes are a little bit tedious, but you know, I'm guessing they're gonna thin out as we get further in. You know, I really get a feeling like if you take the time to master the item system, You could probably be pretty quick with it. Like, it might be an interesting speed game. I don't know, I might look up a speed run of this game later. Maybe if I let it, like, calm down, I could sneak up on it. Okay. On the ground. Is he like, gonna see me? There we go. That's using your noggin. Is this a... Okay, I guess it is. This is one of those textures that goes places. Red switch. Wait, how do you know that? No, I don't think you did. This is such a bouncy tune. Really gets you energized to go catch monkeys. You know, I know that this is like supposed to be like made out of time travel material or something, but it's kind of amusing that it just looked like a butterfly net. Like, I think if I was actually gonna go catch monkeys, I would probably use something, I don't know, a little less likely to get my fingers bitten off. Ooh, this looks perilous. Oh, I see you. I should probably be careful. Come back here. There we go. That's two. Oh, man. That got intense. Gee, no shit. You mean that my little dinky stun club isn't gonna beat a 50-foot T-Rex? Thanks for the information, Doc. Hit it. I thought you... Never mind. You know what? I think I'm gonna come back to this one. That seems a little bit above my pay grade at the moment. I think I'm supposed to get a ranged weapon, right? I'm not gonna hit that guy with a stun club. I mean, sure, I'm going on a time travel adventure and stuff, but I'm not stupid. I'm okay. What does it do? I don't know, but it's shiny. Okay, I need like a monkey radar or something. Around here somewhere. Okay, that's not good. Let's see, monkeys. Where are the monkeys? Where art thou, monkey? No. I didn't miss any over here, I guess. There's some kind of... Is that it? I might have to go for the T-Rex. I was kind of hoping to, go for something a little easier. This is the second level, for Christ's sake. There's really no way up there, huh? Wait, no, I found a... Oh wait, this is the staircase I already went up, so wait, can I... Aha! Is there a monkey up here? No? Maybe not. Hey, there you are. Ha! Take that. Guessing I'm probably not supposed to be, shit. My old nemesis, fall damage. Wait, found one. Yeah. aim with this thing is terrible. Gotcha. There we go.
Yes.
This is a little bit formulaic here. We don't need to sit through that every time.
Hi-ya!
I think we've probably got time for one more. Is there like gonna be a boss level? I don't know. We've got cleared. Okay, so that's just if I beat the level. So I get cleared and I got the coin. And I'm assuming there's gonna be like a 100% mark or two.
Look what I've got, a new gadget. Check
Sweet.
It out.
Here's a monkey radar. It'll help you track those monkeys down. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training room. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful.
I was kidding. All right. I'm not gonna complain. Let's go test out the monkey radar. I seriously didn't know that was gonna happen. I don't have to capture it because I can't. There we go. Of course, I can't do it right now because I'm in the tutorial room. Okay, that's pretty handy.
Spike. You're now on your way to the mysterious time of the jungle ruins. You must navigate through thick jungles filled with beasts never seen before. Go on to explore the temple ruins, but be very careful. The temple is laden with treacherous pathways and dark dungeons. Oh yes, and you may have already noticed one thing. The apes have varying fields of vision, so in most cases you can sneak up on them by crawling around rather than running after them. You won't be noticed as quickly if you remain low to the ground. You'll discover many great things on your journey, but try to stay focused. You must locate all of the apes. Every second that passes gives Specter a chance to succeed. We're counting on you.
Does it technically matter how many seconds pass? I mean, they're in the past, and it... time travel, right?
Hello, Professor. Remember me? It's me, Specter, the future leader of the new age. That's right. Apes will soon rule the world, just as it should have been from the beginning.
But... don't...
Specter, what's going on here?
Never mind.
What are you planning to do?
Specter, oh yes. You're the monkey that performs at the amusement park.
What? He's that cute little monkey that everyone loves to come and see? But how?
Yes, that's right. I stumbled onto this incredible invention of yours, this peak point helmet, and it's given me remarkable knowledge and great powers. And now, I plan to rule the world, and I owe it to you, Professor.
Specter, you must listen to me carefully. It's true that the peak point helmet will augment your intelligence to heightened levels when it's worn. However, it is still incomplete. It's never been tested and may be very dangerous to use. I insist that you bring the Peak Point helmet back to me immediately.
Bring it back? Are you kidding? I'm sorry, Professor, but it's too late. I've already made duplicate helmets for my new army of apes. There's no stopping us now. The future is mine! Don't try and trick me into giving this helmet back, Professor. I'm smarter than you. I even figured out how to use the time station. I've already sent my armies back in time to rewrite history. No longer will humans be the dominant species. I will rule this world. Don't bother trying to stop me.
Huh. Spike will find you. Just wait, you'll see. We're not gonna stand around and let you take over.
Spike? That little runt? He doesn't scare me. I've got a surprise for him.
Jake!
Oh, shit.
I've always wanted to go up against you. Now here's my chance. I'm gonna have a great time destroying you and showing you who's the real hero.
What's happening? What's wrong with you? Do you realize what you're saying? Do you know who you're talking to? Snap out of it! Pull yourself together! Can you hear me?
It's no use. Somehow he's been brainwashed and he's being controlled by Specter.
That's right, Professor. You're very perceptive. The boy you see here isn't the same anymore. He works for me now. I'm in control, and no one can stop me, especially not you. Well, I've got to go now, but I'm sure we'll be talking again soon.
All right, enough theatrics. We've only got like a few minutes left. I don't know why I gesture when I talk, because no one can see me doing it. Maybe I really should get a face cam or something. I don't know. I'd have to find a webcam. I don't actually own one right now, except for the built-in crap on my laptop. Hello, mailbox. Right. I got it. Let's see. Monkey radar. Okay. No, he is in here. Right? No, wrong. Shit. This one? No. Why are there so many bees? Shit. Come on. There we go. I think it might be this one. Come back here. Fuck. Well, that wasn't my most dignified moment. I don't think it hurt, did it? There we go. I'll see. Now this one's got sunglasses and an Uzi. God dang it. They move. Well, that was a little brute force, but I got it. No good. Doing nothing. I don't know exactly what they're going for here. I guess I'll figure it out later. Come back here. Circles. Fuck. I need a longer range weapon. That's number three. Are there any more? Guess we're going this way. Ooh, okay. I shouldn't use the radar through the load screens because that's freaking annoying. Something on the other side of this. Okay, no good. Guess we're going back for now. There's a lot of monkeys on this level too. It was like 14, was it? Follow the radar. That's enough of you guys. Is there any way to get up here? There we go. Next question, was I supposed to get up here? Maybe not. Let's go this way. And we're a little over, but I think I can finish this level. Boy, alright. That's terrifying. That's, oh my god. This is weird to control. Yeah, I gotta hand it to them. They're definitely making use of the whole double stick thing. If you see something strange, just, you know, hit it. Why not? Don't tell me I've actually got to get there in time. That sounds like a recipe for disaster. Yeah, I don't think so. What's with this? Guess I've got to give it a try. Everyone can watch me embarrass myself at rowing a boat. Hold on. I think I may have messed up. Okay, forget the boat. I said forget the boat. We're just gonna swim for it. Go. Huh, there we go. That's much better. Come on. Ow. Screw that. There we go. Two more left. All this water freaks me out. Especially with monster fish. I hear a monkey. Where is it? Guess I can't pull out the radar right now. Monkey's in the water, then I'm just not gonna even bother. Not with that thing swimming around down there. Alright, let's go. It's a good thing that this thin sheet of rubber is protecting me from that monster fish. Who knows what would happen if I didn't have it. Monkey. Come on. Yeah. Ow. That almost worked.
Gotcha.
Get in the net. There we go.
Yeah.
But I hear a monkey.
Hi-ya.
Yes. Thanks, guys. Good to know. What? I don't need the cookie jar. What I need is to capture that monkey. Dang it! What the fuck? Okay, I changed my mind. I need the cookie jar. The ancient ancestor of the Whomping Willow. I can, but it's inconsistent. Frickin' hell. It's a good thing they gave me infinite life for this. Sorry for going over time, guys. They just really want to beat this stage. Not so strong with your without your plant controlling powers, huh? Frickin' monkey.
You did great.
Awesome. Okay, well, that is probably a good time to wrap up. So, that's all for this episode of Gaming Archaeology. Probably going to see you next time on Mischief Makers, unless something really interesting comes up that I want to do at first. But Mischief Makers deserves its time in the spotlight, so I will see you then. Bye-bye.